Good afternoon, students. In our last lecture, we have studied about concept of disability and disorder, meaning of disability, meaning of disorder, types of disability, and other things also. And today, we are going to see types of disorder, their causes, and nature. In this lecture, we are going to study about types of disorder, means ADHD, SPD, ASD, ODD and OCD. Now we will see the full form of types of disorder. The first one is ADHD, Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. The next is SPD, means Sensory Processing Disorder. ASD, Autism Spectrum Disorder. Next is ODD, Oppositional Defiant Disorder. And the last is OCD, Obsessive Compulsive Disorder. First we will study about ADHD. ADHD means Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder is a group of behavioral symptoms that include inattentiveness, hyperactivity and compulsiveness. In fact, it is a medical condition that affects how well can someone sit still, focus and pay attention. Generally, ADHD affected children have a deficiency in the part of their brains that control activity and attention. It means that such individual may have some problems focusing in some activities. They may be hyperactivities or may be unable to control their impulses. Now we will see ADHD causes. There are two types of causes. One is physiological causes and another is environmental causes. First, we will see physiological causes. In that, cyst in the brain. Next is low birth weight, which is comes under 1.5 kg or 3.3 lbs. Next is post-traumatic subclinical seizure disorder, worms. Another is minimal brain damage from birth trauma and low oxygen level at birth. And the last is post-concussion syndrome. Now we will see what is meant by environmental causes. In these causes, our surrounding environment always affecting on our body. Like the mother smoking cigarettes during pregnancy, the mother consuming alcohol or using drugs during pregnancy, substance abuse, carbon dioxide poisoning, overstimulation, sitting or lack of physical exercise, sniffing solvents like modeling glue, fingernails polish and permanent markers, mercury, manganese and aluminium poisoning, which lead to causes of ADHD. Now we will see the symptoms of ADHD. There are different symptoms of ADHD in children and adults. First, we will see symptoms in children. They usually forget about daily activities. Children have difficulties in organizing routine activities. They usually indulge in daydreaming. They do not like to perform the activities that require sitting still. They are easily distracted. They usually bounce when they sitting, become restless, have some problem in playing quickly, usually talk excessive, do not pay attention and usually make clearance mistakes. Now we will see symptoms which are faced by adults. Symptoms may change with the advancement of age. They may have anxiety attack, be impulsive, have problem in controlling anger. They usually have low self-esteem. They usually remain unorganized. They are easily frustrated. Mood swings and depression are common in such adults. They have problem in concentrating, especially while reading. Now we will see SPD. SPD means Sensory Processing Disorder. Sensory Processing Disorder is a condition in which the brain has difficulties in receiving and responding to information that come in through the sense. In fact, it refers to the way the nervous system receives messages from the senses and then turns them into proper matter and behavioral response. Generally, all the activities such as reading a book or riding a bicycle requires acute processing of sensation. It is some sort of neurological traffic jam that prevents certain parts of the brain from receiving the information required to interpret sensory information accurately. It means the person with SPD may remain unresponsive to anything around him. Even he may fail to give any response to extreme heat or cold or pain. This is all what is meant by SPD. Now, we will see causes of SPD. There are four types of causes. One is genetic causes, low birth weight, environmental factor, and physical causes. Now we will see what is meant by genetic causes. Researchers' studies indicate that children born of adults who have autism spectrum disorder, means ASD, may be at the higher risk for developing SPD. Scientists allude that the causes of SPD are coded into the child genetic material. Second is low birth weight. Low birth weight is also considered one of the causes of SPD. Now we will see environmental factors. Usually children who are adopted often experience SPD due to some restrictions in their early lives or poor prenatal care. The last one is physical causes. Researcher studies have indicated that individuals with SPD have abnormal brain activities when exposed to certain stimuli. Individuals with SPD have difference in brain's structure, which provide a biological basis for the onset of this disorder. Now we will see the nature or symptoms of SPD. Children with sensory processing disorder cannot properly process sensory stimulations from the outside world. Children may be a constant motion or fatigue easily, withdraw when touches, refuse to eat certain foods because of how to food feel when choose, be hypersensitive to certain fabric and only wear clothes that are soft or comfortable for them. Dislike getting her hands dirty. Be uncomfortable with some movements such as swinging, sliding, going down ropes or other incense. Young child may have trouble learning to climb, go down stairs or ride an escalator. Have difficulties handling small objects such as buttons or snaps, and they also sensitive to sound like vacuum cleaner, lawn mowers, hair dryers may be upsetting them. Now we will see what is meant by ASD, Autism Spectrum Disorder. Autism Spectrum Disorder is a disorder that affects development. The word spectrum refers the range of symptoms and their severity. Generally, the young children with ASD have difficulties with communication, language, social skill, and behavior. In other words, spectrum disorder are characterized by social interaction, difficulties, communication, challenge, and tendency to in repetitive behaviors. They don't like to embarrass, they repeat words and actions. They feel difficulties in exercise, their needs and emotions. They are very sensitive to taste, smell and sound. Now we will see the symptoms of ASD. They are getting difficulties in language and communication. Avoid eye contact with others. A tendency to engage in repetitive behavior,
difficulties with social skills. These all are symptoms of ASD, that is autism spectrum disorder. Now we will see the causes of ASD. Researchers' studies show that there is no single causes of this disorder. However, the available data related to this field suggests that this disorder results from different sets of causal factors such as genetic and environmental. So, first we will see genetic factors. Genetic problems seems to play a significant role in ASD. These problems can happen in two ways. The first is that something happens during fetal development that alert a genes. The second way is that the child inherits problematic genes from the both parents. That is why a child is more likely to have ASD if a parent is affected with ASD. The next is environmental factors. In fact, there is no solid evidence to show that ASD can be caused by anything in the environment like diet or exposure to certain drugs or toxins. However, it is also aware that mothers exposed to high level of pesticides and air pollution may also be at a higher risk of having a child with ASD. The last one is brain development. It has been observed that the brain of children with ASD develops differently in growing children. In such children, brain grows at a faster rate during the first 3 years of childhood. Such children have more cells than they require. Even the connections between the cells are not proper. It may be one of the causes of ASD. It is important to keep in mind that these factors by themselves don't cause autism, rather in combinations with genetic factors, they appear to increase risk. Now we will see what is meant by ODD. ODD means oppositional defiant disorder. ODD is a set of group of behavioral disorder called disruptive behavior disorder. It is called by this name because children who have this disorder always tend to disrupt those around them. ODD is one of the most common mental health disorder found in children and adolescents. Physicians define this disorder as a pattern of disobedience, hostile and defiant behavior directed towards authority figures. Individually affected by this disorder usually behave like rebel, argue with adult, refuse to obey. They show revengeful attitude. They have difficulty in making friends and have low self-esteem. They have negativity in their behaviors. They display angers and irritable moods. Now we will see the causes of ODD. In fact, there is no specific or clear-cut causes of ODD. It is widely believed that a combination of various factors such as biological or genetic, physical, psychological, social risk factors play a significant role in the development of ODD. The various causes factors now we have to see. Now we will see the first biological or genetic factor. Children are more susceptible to developing ODD if they have a parents with a history of ADHD or ODD. Also, children may be affected with ODD if their parents had depression or bipolar disorder of exposure to toxins or poor nutrition. The second is physical factors. The presence of ODD trend have been linked to the extent of abnormal amounts of some brain chemicals. These brain chemicals known as neurotransmitters are responsible for proper functioning of our body activities, and it is best for our well-being to have them in a state of balance in our brain. When an imbalance exists and messages are not communicated properly with other parts of brain, the symptoms of ODD may be occur. The third one is psychological factors. Children may develop ODD if they don't have good relation with parents or have neglectful parents or have inability to develop social relationship. The last one is social factors. ODD may be due to inconsistent discipline, divorce, poverty, chaotic environment in the family and exposure to violence. Now we will see OCD. OCD means obsessive compulsive disorder. ODD is a mental health disorder that affected people of all ages and walks of life. It occurs when an individual gets caught in a cycle of obsessive and compulsions. It can be said that persons with OCD are plagued by constant thought of fear that causes them to perform ritual or routines. The disturbing thoughts are called obsessions and ritual are called compulsions. In simple words, OCD is a type of mental disorder that causes repeated unwanted thoughts. Person suffering from OCD might understand that their obsessions are unreasonable, but trying to stop or ignore them causes anxiety and stress. There are some symptoms of OCD which may range from mild to severe. The main obsessions are followed: a fear of harm to yourself or loved one, fear of contamination by germs, having excessive doubt on any individual, a fear of being embarrassed, a fear of getting dirty, a fear of making mistakes. Now we will see some main compulsions. Repairing things or always moving items to keep them in exact order, bathing or washing hands several times, checking things over and over again, repeating specific words, hoardings, constant praying, persistently counting while doing usual tasks. Now we will see the causes of OCD. The exact causes of OCD is still unknown. Researchers' studies suggest that there may be a problem with the way one part of the brain sends information to another part. Stress and anxiety do not cause OCD, but they may worsen the symptoms of OCD. Recent studies have indicated that there may be a considerable genetic basis for OCD. Depression is also to be a cause of OCD, but the expert opinion is split. This is all for today's lecture. Remaining part we will see in our next lecture. Take care.